Line 5 is a pipeline that moves toxic petroleum products from Superior, Wisconsin to Ontario through the Great Lakes watershed as a shortcut to Canada. It is owned and operated by Enbridge, a $65 billion multinational corporation.
Enbridge has continued to operate the pipeline on the Bad River Reservation, despite expired easements and a legal obligation to remove the pipeline. Knowing that it will have to leave, Enbridge has identified an alternative route that would barely skirt the reservation. Any spill could still contaminate the watershed and the area's many rivers. The Cuckagan Sluice is at risk. It was named one of Wisconsin's 100 wetland gems and a wetland of international importance as a Ramsar site because it is the only remaining extensive coastal wild rice bed in the Great Lakes region. Copper Falls State Park is at risk. The pipeline would cross the Bad River and the Tyler Forks River just upstream of the iconic Brownstone Falls. Countless spring holes and wetlands are at risk. They recharge the aquifers and provide sweet, clear drinking water to locals. They are at risk. Countless creeks and streams, perfect homes for native brook trout and the fingerlings that hatch after the Lake Superior brown trout navigate to the headwaters of the Bad River watershed uplands in the Pennoke Mountains. They are at risk. Billy Creek is at risk. It is one of two Class 1 trout streams in Ashland and Iron County. Alina Edelman was raised on this land, played in Billy Creek, camped, saunaed, and had full course Sunday dinners with many school and 4-H friends here. About Line 5, she says, "Oil is dead. Any new pipeline continues to threaten the contamination of the Lake Superior watershed. This plan is futile at best, a catastrophe at worst." She has good reason to fear. Enbridge has already been fined over $1 million for over 100 violations of state water protections in Wisconsin. Line 5 alone has spilled around 30 times since its inception. And after taking on all of this risk, none of the energy produced will be used in Wisconsin. Line 5's route through our waterways is just a shortcut to Canada. It's no wonder, then, that landowner Sarah Moses has said, "I don't believe this project is in the public interest. We, the landowners along the Line 5 reroute corridor, would be taking on the burden of substantial risk to our homes, wells, and environment from the construction and operation of the pipeline. Yet, we receive no benefit from the operation of Line 5, since none of the product it carries is used by consumers in Northwest Wisconsin."
The good news is that there is still time to save our precious waterways and homes. The Department of Natural Resources is having a public hearing on July 1st at 4 p.m. to discuss whether to grant Enbridge waterway and wetland permits. We need you to show up at that meeting and to submit comments.